How are you?
I'm doing great. Are you ready to be wowed again today?
Please do. Wow me.
Let's see what's in the mystery box.
Okay.
What's in the mystery box?
Thank you very much. Oh. Look at this happy man here.
Day of days.
This is
a beautiful craft beer.
Ooh. There's so much to tell. There are so much stories by, excuse me. hello.
Oh, that's good.
That's good, huh?
That's good. Let me try it. Ooh. Andreas, can you tell me a bit quickly what the difference is between a regular beer and a craft beer?
I think craft beer should be handcrafted, okay. brewed in a small batch with only the best ingredients.
Okay, hey.
I agree.
we need to share this, okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
I can share sometimes.
You can share sometimes, okay. But let's go watch the video first.
Okay.
And know more about our beer.
See you in a bit.
Hey, share.
No.
Can you name the three most popular drinks in the world? The answer is water, tea, and beer. Coincidentally, beer is among the beverages that Taiwanese people drink most often. According to the studies, in the year 2021 alone, Taiwanese people consumed over 510 million liters of beer, including different kinds of flavorful craft beer. Craft beer has received a massive popularity among customers in the past few years, and it has also become a fashionable beverage for the younger population. Craft beer, as defined by the American Brewers Association, is a type of beer produced independently through traditional methods, and craft beer isn't brewed as frequently, so it can be more difficult to find. To many brewers, craft beer is a combination of art and science, the mixture of wheat, hops, yeast, water, and different ingredients can create an entire universe of flavors. Back in 2002, Taiwan legalized home brewing after joining the WTO. Although it was still hard for people to get their hands on ingredients, a group of young brewers saw it as an opportunity. They incorporated domestic fruits and plants, such as longan, guava, and jasmine, into the brewing process and created innovative craft beers that are unique to Taiwan. And some of them have even made a name in the international scene. So, let's get to know craft beer today. Cheers!
Happy.
Happy. Isn't happy?
Is this a
what,
dark?
What kind
beer?
Of beer is this?
Can you tell? Because I'm actually like I just like drinking it. I don't know much about it.
Yeah. Nice sugar flavor.
Nice sugar flavor. Okay, so yeah, I think Marcy
flavor.
Has the answer.
Okay, she has a good
one. This is our beer.
Oh, it's your beer.
I recognize it.
Oh, this is your baby.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's his beer.
Hey, what? How come?
I can recognize the smell. I've drank that many, many times. It's a wee heavy, which is a strong Scotch ale. It's a little bit different than a stout in the fact that it's got a more caramelized and chocolate flavor than a
and it's not as thick
coffee
as a stout.
Or roasty. Not as thick.
Yeah. It's very nice.
If you like easy to drink at a light 9%.
Right.
Oh!
Right.
Well, that's why I like it.
Oh my God. I need some, sorry, waiter. I need one as well.
There you go.
Got one right here.
So let's talk about your beer. You have your own brewery?
Yeah, I've been in Taiwan for about 10 years. Our brewery's been going since 2014, so about 8 years.
Wow.
Can I have a look?
Sure. This is, Brown Sugar Daddy.
Hey,
Sugar
hey,
Daddy.
Yeah.
Named
brown
after the,
sugar
the
daddy.
Local ingredient. Brown sugar.
And what's a wee in the wee heavy?
Small, like Scottish.
Ah,
A wee bit heavy.
A wee bit heavy. Wow, so brewing beer in the US compared to brewing in Taiwan, what's the difference? The water, the...
I honestly have never brewed in the United States. I've only brewed in Taiwan.
So it started like as for fun, kind of like a...
Yeah, well, it started out of necessity, I think. I wanted to have American-style IPA and pale ales, and they were very difficult to find in this market.
Wow.
He wasn't satisfied with Taiwan.
8 to 10 years ago, right. Mind you. Very different.
There really wasn't much choice out there, apart from Taipei, Jingdian, Jingpai, and then Shibatian.
Right.
And then all the other imports. Yeah.
All the other imports, but to have like the actual goodie that he wants, right. He decided to make it himself.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. That's the cool thing about craft beer. Like,
so the cool thing about Brett is he refused to teach English.
Really?
He decided to brew beer.
Point.
Really good
point. That's really cool.
So, like, are there like? I remember that there's a kind of like a rule in terms of. Was there a law at one point that had like some kind of like a restriction on ingredients that go into beer? Like, is there the same thing for craft beer? Like, do you have like a base or like a standard?
Because no, that's a totally different story.
Okay.
Andreas, right. you're from Germany.
From Germany,
right?
Yes.
Are there laws or are there like rules?
Yes, we have a purity law in Germany, and this is came out 1516, I think.
Wow.
And the brewer in Germany still have to brewing according this. It's not really a law, it's a rule.
Okay.
Of course, you can brew other things with fruits, but you cannot call this drink beer.
Oh, so it's kind of like a legality thing, like the terminology.
Right.
Beer is only made with these ingredients, right. Anything else, and it's not beer. What are the ingredients, by the way?
What are the ingredients?
Normally, barley.
Barley is this guy, huh?
Barley. I cannot see that. Sorry.
I'm sorry. Is this one?
Yes. Right.
Yes, this is barley. And
this is the hops. Right?
This is what my guinea pig eats.
Yes.
This is the same thing. It looks. This is hops.
Yes.
Smell it.
Guinea pig might not like
it. I don't think your guinea pig would eat that.
Oh my god! That's a happy guinea pig.
It's related, but not the same thing.
Not the same thing.
No.
Hey. It smells so nice.
It does smell really refreshing. It has a lot of unique flavor.
Oh, sorry, what's this called again?
Hops.
Hops.
Oh, no, one leg. Yeah.
And what else? Water?
Water.
And this guy I know. I'm a baker. This is sourdough starter. The same thing, is it?
I mean, it's yeast, right? It's a culture, so...
Whoa!
No, don't do that, don't do that. Carbon dioxide.
Oh, wow.
But you just add a bit of this into your mixture, right?
Yeah, the wort.
The what?
The wort.
Wort?
Yeah, made by the malt and the hops, we brewed at the first day.
Okay. And then that will kickstart the fermentation of the beer and start the flavors getting all mixing and happy. And it creates the alcohol.
Oh.
This is really important.
Yeah. This is nice. Just then, Andrew saw that beer and was so excited. You love craft beer.
I love beer. It's like so accessible. It's so, I mean, like the tape says, you know, it's one of the most popular drinks. It's basically fun tasting water to me.
Yes, happy water. But happy water. I'm just curious from the perspective of brewers, why do you think people love craft beer so much?
I often compare that with food. Like some food chain, they sell their burger everywhere in the world, and the burger tastes the same wherever you go.
Right.
The commercial beer is brewed for the masses.
Yeah, but it has a very like accessible kind of profile, and it's very consistent, right? That's the thing that they go for.
Right.
Whereas the craft beer, you can have some more outliers and surprises. And...
Right.
For me, craft beer just carries more characters. It's more experimental.
Yes.
It's got more different kind of flavors. You can find all crazy kind of flavors in craft beers. Mm-hmm.
What's the most craziest flavor you've ever came to?
Umami.
Oh.
Spicy.
Oh.
Spicy beer.
Yeah, you can find spicy beers.
Right.
Sour beers.
Do you put seafood in your beer for brewing? Have you ever heard?
I mean, I personally brewed one.
What? Oh, no.
You did. You brewed one.
I did.
What did you put in? Oysters or?
That
yes, people brew oyster stouts, which is really good. And it's a very traditional style.
Yeah, it's really good. I've had an oyster stout.
Marcy, did you have
oyster stout before?
Yeah, sure. But I think people love the craft beer because it's more artist techniques mm-hmm. in the beer production. That's why. Mm,
yeah. Yeah, stuff. It's more like art than like science. You know, kind of like go crazy with it.
Yes. I know her beer very well because I drink it almost like every 2 weeks.
I get
big bottles. I'm not a crazy beer drinker, but okay. I love her creation, Ban De Pi Jiu.
Oh, yeah. That's really cool.
What do you put inside?
Basil. I think basil is quite representative of the Asia cuisines because that's a special herbs. And it's pretty cool when you had that beer, you can remind you the stir-fried clams.
Yes.
Hence the bando.
Yeah, bando means...
It's like a festival, kind of like an outdoor dinner party.
Yes,
outdoor dinner. Taiwanese gathering.
Yeah.
If you ever run into an outdoor party...
Right, if you see like a tarp kind of like spilt all over the street and a bunch of tables with plastic...
Red tables and the
plastic on top and they're plastic, red, pink plastic bowls.
Yes, that's called bando, very, very Taiwanese. Yeah. So I think the name is super cute, super Taiwanese, and the flavor as well.
Yeah.
Have you guys used local Taiwanese ingredients in your beer, like special stuff? Yes, Daisy?
Personally, I like to use beers to tell a story of a place.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
So I would gather the special ingredients from one place and then create a story.
Mm-hmm.
The seafood is, what's it called? Flying fish?
Oh, flying fish.
Yeah, I think that's the craziest local ingredients I ever put in my...
You put the whole fish in?
Not as crazy, not
like
that
Like a fish in one bottle,
I wouldn't go that far. I wish I could, but actually, according to the beer making law, I don't think I could.
Oh.
This guy's angry.
This guy's like, no, you don't do that.
I heard that you had a pretty interesting background in terms of beer. Do you have a special job title?
A job title? Oh, well, compared to all brewers,
they're
scientists.
I'm more like a sommelier.
A sommelier? Okay.
Yeah,
a beer sommelier?
Yes.
What does that mean?
It means I don't work in a brewery. I work in, I serve beers. And I tell, beer stories and everything.
So kind of like a 品酒師?
Yes.
So So
you can put all kinds of ingredients inside. There's seafood, there's juice, there's
fruit.
Honey as well. What else, Doug?
Oh, you can put in it. I mean, anything in it, really, whatever you like. I know one guy that put a piece of pizza in the beer.
You put a pizza in the beer?
Absolutely, yeah.
You sure that's not a starter?
No, it wasn't the starter. But I think craft beer, it's about variety, right? And when you have craft beer, you can make a lot of different things.
Right.
And so then it gives people choices. And I've always said that there is no perfect beer, there are only perfect beers.
Mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
so you can have a beer for each person, and then you can go in and experiment and then decide what you like.
Yeah.
Oh, have you tried brewing at home?
I've made mead, but not beer. I haven't done beer yet.
And mead is not beer?
No.
Mead is mead.
Mead is honey.
Wine.
And honey wine.
Honey wine.
Yeah, and then sometimes it's a little bit bubbly.
Right.
It's really refreshing, really dry. You can add a lot of stuff into it. And, it's pretty fun. It's like really simple. Just water and honey and yeast.
Anything to say, Brent? Is that easy? Honey, yeast.
I think
beer
is
a little easier
than beer because the fermentation temperature is a little bit more forgiving.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
With beer, you have to ferment at a colder temperature.
Right.
When I was doing it, I had a closet that I used and I destroyed an air conditioner.
Just like stuffing it in there and keeping it cold?
Trying to keep it cold enough to make a fermentation that didn't have any funky flavors.
Right. So. Doug, I wanted to ask you, what do you have before you in front of you?
We've got the Red Point IPA.
Taipa!
But we call it the Taipa. So instead of using local ingredients, kind of the things we do is we try to look at local places. And so obviously the IPA in Taipei, it's a play on words, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so we wanted to make an IPA for Taiwan because there was no domestically brewed IPA in this country mm-hmm. back when we made this. So we're the first domestically brewed IPA.
Hey, we're kind of thirsty.
Honestly?
Yes, please. We want to listen to your story and at the same time.
Because this actually brings back some memories for me. When I was 21, my cousin introduced me to craft beer culture in the States. And then I kind of got hooked on IPAs.
Hey, thank you.
And then I remember coming back to Taiwan and they didn't have any. I was like, I really missed that flavor. And then you guys came out with this. And then that kind of like, you know, scratched the itch I had for a very long time.
So this is an old friend for you.
Yeah, this brings back.
Oh, wow.
Young memories.
Well,
remember, you have to be an adult to drink and drink responsibly.
Yes, I just turned 18.
It's good to be on this show.
It's good to be on, yeah, it's good to be on this show.
Hey, me too.
Yes. We, you know, we also like to, you know, give homage to Taiwan and some of the areas that are in Taiwan. So we have some other beers that we make, the longan, which is actually a place that my partner and I used to do rock climbing in.
Yes, okay.
Yeah, you know, longan. Everybody, everybody should go visit longan if you ever have a chance. It's a fantastic area.
Yeah.
We also make the rock monkey stout, which is the Miho Pijo, which is the domestic monkey of Taiwan. Yeah. And so we try to give some homage to Taiwan because it's our home, and I've been here for 20 years. And
wow.
20 years.
Yeah, 20 years.
Wow.
So stories in their Taiwanese beer, their versions of Taiwanese beer. It's quite moving for Taiwanese to hear.
Right, you know? Mm. And I'm going to be honest, this isn't going to be enough. I just heard Andreas say, go like, that's it, so little. So we're going to try a few more. After this break.
Yep, we'll be right back. Cheers!
Cheers! Woohoo! Wow!
And this is daylily. Daylily flower.
Zhonghua.
And why did you want to bring it in your beard?
I don't want.
Okay, sorry.
Whoa.
Wow.
That is very, very unique. What gave you the inspiration to put fish in beer?
We're gonna introduce some really, really nice crafted beer.
This actually looks like a pretty pre-arranged and robust meal. We got protein.
Yes, well, this is dinner. We have here flying fish. And this was what Daisy talked about.
Right.
She tried to put in some seafood while brewing her beer.
I can see why she couldn't put a whole fish in the bottle now.
Well, it's quite big. She would have fit. And we have
basil. That's
Marcy's beer.
And that's tea.
Yes.
The red oolong.
Oh,
specialty from Taiwan.
Nice.
Oh,
that smells really good.
So tea in beer.
Fruits,
passion fruit, and grapefruit.
Okay. Love those. Those are my favorite.
And this is.
I have no idea. What is that? Can I taste it?
One shot.
I have no idea what that is.
No way.
It's like tea, but that's really tasty. It's like an herb tea.
Herb tea.
All right, we'll find out later.
We'll find out. And this is daylily. Daylily flower. Also from Taidong as well?
Probably.
From
Palian. Palian. Okay.
All right, enough about the food.
Yes, straight to the beer. We have six beers here.
Okay, I'm just going to draw one at random.
Come on.
What is this? Changbing Yingxiang. Ga Kavan. Specialty lager.
Whose beer is this?
Oh,
Daisy, come on up.
Come on up.
Let's talk about your beer.
Tell us about your beer.
Right. So this is the one that supposed to brew with the flying fish.
Hey, I'm vegetarian.
But you're not vegan. So there's no meat.
No meat, right?
Okay. And it's only extract of its aroma.
It smells so good.
Yes, but the flying fish aroma is not in the bottle yet. You need a final.
Okay, so this is vegetarian.
This is vegetarian.
This is
not.
Okay, Andrew, give it a
let's
try.
Let's go.
Is it like
fish me?
Fish stock.
There you go.
Oh, wait. That is really.
Hey, it's interesting.
Yeah. Whoa.
Wow.
That is very, very unique. So what gave you the inspiration to put fish in beer? Was it a dream?
Well, not in my craziest dream had I ever thought about putting a fish in my beer, but actually, because I made this beer during the pandemic, my beer nomad project has have to stop. So yeah, because which I suppose to travel to different places, work with different people, and then have different pop-up bars.
Okay.
But I couldn't do that, but I thought, well, I can make beers and then bring different places to your house, right?
Right.
So I decided to make this beer so I can bring the Taidong
to the world.
I know,
to the other, to the rest of the world.
I let your neighbor Andres taste it.
How do you like it?
He was like, the word you said was...
Interesting.
It's supposed
interesting.
It's polite.
That's very polite.
It's supposed to be interesting.
It feels like a meal, you know? Like,
yeah. Yes.
I have one question.
Yeah.
Yes.
I don't know how to say.
Go ahead.
You can say it in German.
I think it's drinkable, but I wonder how you want or why you want to call that is a beer.
Because
it's very strict.
Strong words from the German.
Because we don't have purity law in
Taiwan. Oh, freedom and creativity.
All right.
Thank you, Daisy.
I think there is a lot of people that will like it.
Yeah.
But for me, if I drink it, I don't have any imagination about beer, you know?
Okay, so I would like to know how you imagine your beer. Please come up and choose your beer.
Put your money where your beer is.
Imagination. Yeah, which one is your beer?
This one.
The big bottle.
The Day Lilies.
Wow. Can't wait for
the Day Lilies, so it's this, right?
right.
Day Lilies, my mom uses this in soup.
Yes.
Yes, and maybe some stir fries.
Right.
So, do you have this in Germany?
I think some people have it in their garden.
Do they use it?
No.
No, just okay. for. Like,
I never heard about it.
Pretty. And why did you want to bring it in your beer?
I don't want.
Okay,
I'm
sorry.
So German.
No, we live.
So German. I don't know.
You're just so brutally honest.
I didn't want to.
They forced
Who
my
forced
hand.
You?
Actually, my better half.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yes.
We're living in the mountains, and in that area, the people they grow a lot of this stuff.
Yes.
Almost everywhere around us, daylilies are growing. And the people just dry that.
Yeah.
And for soup or for tea.
Yes.
And they're looking for other products making from their daylily. So my girlfriend had the idea to make a beer from that.
Right. And you weren't happy.
Right.
No, just kidding. I want to try this so bad.
Interesting.
Hey. Interesting.
It's interesting. How come I taste cheese?
No, the smoke you...
Oh, it's from her, Daisy!
Oh, right. You still smell the smoke in the air. The fish is right there, too.
The smoke is
Andrew,
from the day lily.
Smoked cheese.
I see that. I totally get where you're coming from.
I'm not joking. Marcy, what do you eat? What do you drink? What do you taste?
Like the caramel candy.
Caramel candy? Yeah, it's kind of sweet.
Doug.
I know, I get what you're saying.
Smoked cheese?
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
Anybody of you taste daylily?
I do.
Really?
I do.
I don't even know what daylily
is. It's on the aftertaste. Daylily has a very, very delicate fragrant flavor that you usually get on the soup, but only when you smell it, not when you taste it. So at the very end, when your tongue is kind of drier, there's that kind of sweet fragrance that kind of comes off of the top of the soup, like the flavor of the flour. It's a very subtle flavor. It's very delicate. And you look kind of like a really strict vegetarian right now. Are you doing okay?
I think it's really interesting. If I tell this to my mom, she won't believe this can, you know, be crafted in a beer.
Well, I mean, you put it in soup.
You can put everything in beer.
Yeah.
You can ask them.
Right. Pizza. So are you happy with your product, your baby?
Fish.
People like it.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm happy.
Interesting. Wow. Are you proud? People like it.
No,
so German.
Anyway, I cannot really say I taste it daily.
Okay.
Yeah, people, when we move to the mountain, people offer the daily, and I was thinking, why they eat that?
Yeah. So this is an experiment, kind of like an experiment.
Right. A successful experiment.
Right. What's your next experiment?
I try to make banana wine.
Banana wine.
Wow.
That sounds interesting.
Is it successful now?
Seems like.
Okay.
I'm gonna go find you.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go see.
We should do a wine episode and have him come back.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Wow, daylily.
Daylily. Surprising.
Okay, so we have this taken.
Okay,
and this one taken.
All right.
Okay.
You want to choose the next one?
I want to choose the next
one. All right.
Okay, let's see. You know, my family is a tea drinker.
Okay.
So I think I'll choose the red oolong.
Red oolong.
Who's this from?
Who's that?
Yours.
Yeah. Come on up, please.
I think have more of champagne.
Yes, it's more
tea
like
tea in beverages is very normal.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But putting them brewing in a beer.
Yeah.
Because how did you get the idea?
Because I've been to a tea-related cocktail bar in Tokyo.
Yes.
And I think Asia has a really good tea culture.
Especially Taiwan.
Yeah,
yes,
we also have good tea. But we don't have good tea beer. So we would like to make the tea culture and the beer culture like good engagement.
Right.
Because people in Taiwan asking you, would you like to have a tea?
Yes.
It's like a chart time starting.
Yes.
Yeah. So we would like to make tea culture and beer culture together. Red oolong tea is different processing than oolong. So more fruity. So we.
I'm getting some nods over there.
This is really good, Marcy.
Yes, so tea inside.
It's interesting.
Yeah. But is it successful? Successful for you?
Andreas, what do you think? Did you try it?
Yes, I try. I think it's not bad. Actually, I have to say, I already tried several kind of tea beer in Taiwan, and I think tea and beer fit together.
Yeah, they really do. They really do.
Well, Doug, you said this is really good.
Yeah, I think this is amazing. I think the fact that you got the tea to come through so strongly is the artisanal part right there. Yeah. Honestly, that's why it's craft beer.
So keeping the tea flavor in the beer is difficult?
It's quite difficult because we have different tea types. Mm-hmm. So we develop the oolong tea, the baozhong tea, and also sweet tea, like a winter melon tea or the traditional herbal tea.
Okay.
Yeah, so different type of tea into beer and combined with different beer style are difficult.
Right,
yeah.
So this is the winner of all the experiments.
It's a little release this season.
Yeah, from our brewery.
Wow. I agree. This is quite something. This feels really nice after, you know, a day of work where you're kind of tired, but you're not, you know, zonked out. You're like, you know, a little pick-me-up. Tea, you know, feel elegant because like you're having high tea.
Like, stop drinking beer.
It's tea.
Oh, sorry. Yes, I like this so much. It's so refreshing, so light.
Yeah. Cheers. Congratulations,
Cheers,
Marcy.
Thank you, Marcy.
Wow. Very cool.
So Marcy was talking about some people put fruits inside, some people put herbal tea inside.
Right.
We just tasted this, and till now, we don't know what this is. But maybe some vegetarian stuff. What is this? Who can answer me?
Can the real culprit please raise their hand?
I think that's mine.
You think it's yours again?
Yeah,
you
that again. Would be me again.
You got
okay,
double.
Please come up.
All right, come on.
Which one?
蓝眼泪吗？蓝眼泪，蓝眼泪。
The blue tears.
Mazu herbal tea.
It kind of was. It has like a licorice aftertaste when I tried it.
Oh my god, so much beer! Yes, what a day.
The day of days.
Right, this is very interesting.
Whoa!
Wait, mind the head, but hey, we can see the bluish beer here. How come?
He I can pour better. I can pour better. Yeah. That just surprised me. It just scared me.
Because I wanted to make a beer that would represent my image of Mazu. And what's the most famous thing in Mazu?
Lanyanlei, the blue tears of Mazu.
Yes. So that's why I decided to brew a blue beer, which, and supposedly there's supposed to be a little bit glitter inside.
Sorry. Glitter!
Yes. So it was
shiny. I can only see the head.
Maybe. My bad. It's my fault.
Inside? No, maybe it's in the bottom
of the bill.
Yes.
Okay, so I'll give it a little gentle swirl.
Yeah.
Mmm. But have you tasted it yet?
No.
Go for it. Sorry. Chuck you down.
Thank you, Patty.
Ooh. Interesting.
Yes, very.
It's very floral, fruity.
No. Yes. No. Yes. Hoppy. There's a bit of a hoppiness to it. It's kind of got that nice bitterness, so it's kind of crisp.
Mm-hmm. And some meaty.
Yeah, and meaty, right?
Minty.
Oh,
minty. Minty.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Doug.
What do you think?
I like it. I like it a lot, actually.
People love it so much, I was really surprised. Because when I brewed this beer, I wasn't very confident. Because I was like, who wants to drink this?
Right. I do.
I do.
Yeah, apparently
it's magical. People do. It's kind of magical and fantastical. Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you, Daisy.
Thank you so much. This is the first time I drank this much beer at work.
I think life is good.
Life is really good.
This is the first time I drink this little beer at work.
I need a job. I need to start making beer.
Red, come on. Let's taste your beer.
Which one is yours? Come on up.
Wow. Happy guy, huh?
Oh, there's more.
Okay.
It's won the biggest five competition in the world, I think.
Wow! Hey, congratulations! That's not easy, yeah.
It's delicious.
Bravo! Yeah. Bravo!
So you're the one who worked with grapefruit.
Grapefruit, right.
And passion fruit at the same time?
Not in this particular beer. We've done several passion fruit beers over the years.
Right.
This one also has green tea in it, so there's trying to balance the grapefruit and the green tea flavor. If you look at our beer portfolio, you'll find it's very heavy on pale ales and IPAs and things. So it's good to bring something a little bit lighter to the table, like you were saying.
Hey, it has a tea smell as well.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of green tea in this.
A lot of green tea in this?
Right. And the green tea turned out to be stronger than the grapefruit. Interestingly.
It did.
It's nice and nice and sweet.
Can I pour you a drink?
Mm-hmm. Cool.
Like, I like it.
Yeah. Yes. It's got milk sugar in it. I don't know if that's a vegetarian issue.
What's milk sugar?
Lactose.
Ah, it's okay. It tastes good. I like it. Well, why do you need to put that ingredient in?
Lactose is not fermentable.
Okay.
So it retains sweetness.
Yeah.
When we're working with sweetness levels in beer, there are like a couple different ways to do it. One is you have an unfermentable sugar.
Right.
Or you try to make the beer less fermentable, so more sugar remains.
Well, this is science class.
Yeah.
Or you can pasteurize it after you put fruit in, so that the fruit sugar
will kill the yeast. Is that what you mean by pasteurizing?
No, the pasteurization, just like you put...
You heat it.
Heat it, yeah. You heat it so that you kill any yeast and or anything inside.
I think
so
I got confused.
You can leave.
Patty, are you okay?
It's a bio-stabilized process.
Are you okay?
Oh, what's that? Yeah. Cheers, man! Who cares about lactose? I care about good drinking beer.
No, this is pretty cool,
Nice, green tea and grapefruit. It's one of the most liked soyao in the
green tea grapefruit.
I was not aware of that.
It's one of my favorites.
Right, that's why you started this flavor?
Maybe.
You didn't know?
No, I'm just kidding, yeah. Yeah, it's Ursulan, so.
Yeah. Oh, that's why it's 23 land.
Yeah.
Wow, this is so nice.
Clever, wow. This is your kind of thing?
Yeah, can I order it from you, please?
Definitely. Yeah.
Definitely.
You're welcome.
I'll tell you when, 12 or 24 cases. Bottles. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Right, thank you. Cheers.
Wow, all these crafted beer. Happy guy, huh?
Oh, there's more!
There's more!
Okay, I'm gonna be honest.
No this, way!
I'm gonna be honest, this is kind of like going, getting out of hand.
So happy the amount of alcohol. Here. Ah, okay.
Now you're disappointed.
What's that? What's that?
Stuffy nose, sorry. What is this?
That's honey. That's honey. We make mead in Taiwan?
I know what this honey is!
You know what it's for?
I know what kind of honey this is.
Well, what is it? What is it?
Longan. Longan mee. Longan honey.
Longan honey.
Yes. Why is it up here? Who knows? Who knows?
Is there like a particular kind of winner or a particular kind of specialty beer that we didn't know about until now?
Yes.
Oh, of course it is. Do you wanna, could you tell me why?
Honey beer is our powerful beer mm-hmm. in our brand.
So it's won a couple of awards, hasn't it?
Oh yes. It's won the biggest five competition in the world, I think.
Wow, hey, congratulations. That's not easy, yeah.
In this year, they have 10,000 beers entries and from 2,500 breweries. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it's really big one.
Pride of Taiwan.
But every time after that, my boss will ask him, what's the next awards?
Right.
Oh my God, big
Which
pressure.
Which one can we sign up for?
Hey, I think your boss is watching. Do you want to speak to him?
Just to say that. Yeah,
excuse
next
me.
No problem.
Not that much pressure. Drink a bit. Oh, so this is honey flavored beer?
Right.
Not mead.
Okay.
Yeah. So we fermented all the sugar in the honey. Mm-hmm. So it's not blending like cocktails. We truly adding honey mm-hmm. into the wort preparation. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah. So in a hot pot, hot block.
Hot pot?
I think that's what she said.
Hot block.
So we are going into the brewing technique.
Right. That was a very technical term.
Okay. I just noticed that.
You kind of lost us right there. We just like
brewing,
drinking
brewing,
the beer.
I need to talk about
that. Hey, we have another award winner.
I know.
Yes,
right?
Doug. Your long dong.
Yeah, the long dong. We won an award for best American lager in Asia.
Mm. Wow. God.
Years back, yeah.
What's the name of the awards?
The Asia Beer Awards.
Asia Beer Awards.
So all of Asia best lager.
Okay.
So
it's not easy.
It was nice.
Why do you think you won?
I think we make a very crisp and authentic lager. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And I think that's what people like. You know, 80% of the world's drinkers are lager drinkers. Mm-hmm. And so we want to provide something that's representative of what those people like.
Right.
Yeah.
Do you want to be the judge?
I would love to be. I don't know if I'd be good at it.
Well, the tasting skills actually is not that easy. It's not just like I like it or not, but you need a lot of, you know, terms to describe.
You have to be able to really be accurate and also like understand the process.
Right.
Andreas, what about European? Like, are there certain like different kinds of awards in Europe?
I only have been once in the World Beer Awards with my alt beer.
Ooh, yay! This is called Lao Pi Jiao.
Yes.
Old beer.
And I became just a Taiwan winner for alt beer.
Wow.
The only one.
An old beer made by a traditional German in Taiwan.
So cute.
That's a really cute slogan.
This is a traditional German beer.
Oh.
Traditional German beer style.
So you won a German beer in a German beer award from Taiwan.
No, this is a World Beer Award.
Oh, it's very dark.
Wow, that's
beautiful. I do much better than you, hello.
You have all night. You are way better at me.
This is very amberish color, right?
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Yeah, so how do you describe a very German beer?
It's delicious.
Bravo. Yeah. Bravo.
It is so different.
Really?
Please.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Just go for it.
I have a quick question before I do this and then disappear from reality. But I wanted to ask, like, how does the judging process work? Do you just like have a rager and then wake up the next day and be like, yeah, I like that one. I remember that one. Right. Or like, is there like a process? Like, how does it work? Marcy, like, how do you make it work?
Yeah, as a judge, we will have a different groups. You drink directly?
Do you want some? Sorry.
At least some cups.
Oh, okay, perfect, perfect. I'm so sorry.
Like she honestly wants some.
Yeah, no, no, she straight up just called me out.
Yeah, hey, hey, bro, 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 wait.
So as a judge, we following the international beer style, thank you, beer style guidelines, and we work in the different groups. And we also followed the rules of the scores of that competitions. Okay. So after the discussion and tasting, we decided who have no off flavors, who can get some medals.
It's a long process then.
Yeah, I just been to the International Beer Cup last month in Japan, mm-hmm. and we judging for 3 days.
Okay.
So tasting and tasting and tasting.
And getting drunk and then wake up.
And then tasting drunk, more.
And then wake up.
And the way I like Japanese guy, because when we write down the comments, they remind us it's the love letter to brewers and the breweries to make them, help them to make better beer.
Brett was laughing.
Like, that sounds interesting.
He heard right. love letter.
Say
he's
love
like,
letter?
Yeah.
That sounds really romantic. So it's like, oh, I love you, but we have to break up. This beer isn't really working out for me.
I think you can do better this and that, but I love you.
Yeah. Yes. And the other one is like, oh, I can't wait for our future together.
Love letter.
Yeah,
that's a nice Japan description.
Style. Wow, gosh. And so you guys must have tried so many different types of beers during that competition. And I'm actually pretty curious because I don't really know like how many different types of beers there are.
Yes. But
I think maybe we should have some water, take a break.
No, I don't need that. I need just more beer, but we'll have more when we come back.
See you soon. Wow! And then a lager and an IPA are close, right? One's a pale ale. No, sorry, a lager and an ale. Sorry, I got messed up.
I am so confused. French, save him, save him. Doug, we should let the professional teach you how to pour,
okay?
You've already messed up so many beers.
Tilt it a little bit.
Tilt it. Roughly 45 degrees.
Roughly, that's way more than 45 degrees. Yeah.
Okay. Welcome back to
Wild Taiwan.
Oh, wow. We tasted so many different kind of beers, really Taiwanese style, brewed in Taiwan.
Like handmade.
Yes.
Hand selected.
Yes, but okay, now if I want to go to a restaurant, I really don't know how to pick my beer.
That's a really good question.
Maybe I'll just ask the waiter or the bartender that I want something a bit sweet, not so bitter, maybe a bit floral or fruity, easy drinking.
Is that a good way to do it, you guys? Like, do you recommend that method? Or?
Absolutely. If you go to a tap room, the servers are going to know exactly what they can serve you, and you tell them what you want, and they're going to make a recommendation.
But will I sound silly if I just say I want something not so bitter?
Oh, absolutely.
No,
not.
I'm okay. Oh, good.
So like, there's
beer, beer is unpretentious.
Beers, yeah.
Okay.
It's the everyman drink.
It's the everyday drink.
Friendly, friendly. Doug, what would you recommend me ordering?
Well, that one right there. That one's for you.
This one right here.
Yeah, no, that's a lager.
He's making some commercials.
Yeah, he's pushing
it's
straight up.
It's your baby.
Yeah, it's my baby.
The award-winning longdong.
Straight up longdong, yep. That's the one for you. You're going to enjoy it.
Oh, okay. Wow. So
he's already got a feeling for your taste. You know?
I know. Wow.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to have this straight up.
Go for it.
Well, we certainly let him. Don't let him pour it.
All right, now I have to redeem myself. Patty, allow me to.
Wait. We should let the professional teach you how to
that's
pour.
A good point.
Okay, you've already messed up so many beers.
I kind of don't think it was entirely my fault, but okay.
Yes. Come on, Daisy. Can you please teach?
Walk me through it again.
Oh, but the taste is so nice. It's so refreshing.
Really?
It's light, fruity.
Okay.
Yes.
I mean. The best way not to mess with him is
to mess with him.
Or just put it in, like, drink
just
it
drink straight out of the bottle.
Yeah, right. But if we want to, you know, smell some more aroma.
Mm-hmm. Go just a few seconds, I'll try to keep
yes.
up.
Okay.
Tilt it a little bit.
Angle.
Tilt it.
Go ahead, go.
Roughly 45 degrees.
Roughly, that's way more than 45.
Roughly.
Okay.
Pour it
gently.
Okay, so you're aiming for that little dip right there. Okay, yes. Okay, stop. Let me try. Okay, let me do it. Because at this point, she's about poured half the beer. So, there we go. And then you
and
want
then
a little bit
of head. Straight back up.
Oh my God, yay!
Yay!
I had some crutches. Thank you.
Thank you, Daisy. Thank you for saving our stomach. Otherwise, I burp and burp. Thank you.
Right. Oh, that's crisp.
It's perfect for summer. Mm. Right. I just saw myself in a, you know, music fest.
Yeah. You know. Yeah. Like, outdoors. There's a breeze. The sun is out. You're like, there's music in the background.
So light. Perfect for summer. Yeah.
Oh wow, that's a very lovely beer.
Look how happy we are now.
Yeah. I never, who knew beer made you so happy?
Yes, but now I think during this episode, we kind of get more to know that how difficult it is to, really craft a handmade beer.
But I also am kind of astounded by how many different types of craft breweries have kind of sprouted up in Taiwan with this kind of new vigor and energy to just like try new things and make new drinks. It's been really inspiring.
To me, they're like artisans, they're scientists, and they're engineers. Well, there's a real engineer there.
Right. He's like a mechanical engineer.
Electrical.
Oh, sorry, electrical engineer.
Oh my God. So it's actually needed very precise. You need some, artistic brain cells inside, imagination, and some precise measuring.
Right.
Otherwise, you'll screw up.
It's alchemy. It's magic.
So you love craft beer, and after this episode,
you
must have... Yes, I'm in love with their creation.
So now you know what to order next time you go out.
Do I?
Get
so
a longan.
What do I say if I want to order this beer? This is a kind of... what's it called?
This would be a lager. An American lager.
Okay.
Thank you guys so much today for taking us on this journey and teaching us about different kinds of beers and the stuff we can kind of find in Taiwan.
Yes, so guys, if you come to Taiwan, our beer is super international. Our people are super nice. So just come and, pick a bar. Just walk in and you'll have really, really nice surprises.
Come find us. Let's grab a drink.
Yes, Taiwan. We'll see you next time.
See you next time.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you.